two things that are sort of heartbreaking, and you can't hear other presidents saying. He said, sometimes I just feel like an asterisk.
I know.
Lost between the glory of Reagan and the trials and tribulations of my sons. And the other key element, I think, was when he argued that he just didn't know that there was enough there. I had written a book about Andrew.
There, meaning in terms of him. What he says, or his historical record, not so much his diaries and his recordings. He worried if there was not that much stuff to write about?
About him. And I know. I have a note from him from 2008, after I'd published a biography of Andrew Jackson, and he writes, it's a little overwhelming to think that I would be following a lion, because I'd called the book American Lion.
A book which won a Pulitzer Prize.
And he said to me afterward, he said, because I'd written about Franklin Roosevelt, Winston Churchill, Andrew Jackson, and he told me, I remember sitting on the porch at Kennebunkport, he said, I'm not FDR, I'm not Churchill, I'm not a lion. And what he was is a unique American odyssey. We shall not see his like again. And he was, part of his appeal is that he didn't think he doesn't understand, even unto this hour, I think, he doesn't fully appreciate the impact he had on the country.